It is nice to be here. Nanubala. You see, when Papa meet, Rekopane on issues that directly affect the life Sabunda that day, it is a glorious day for me. It pleases me to see men, irrespective of the number, it pleases me to see men, Bakopane, Bare, we want to talk about issues that affect us. Irrespective of the organizations to which they belong, when that day, when they meet and say, this is what we're going to talk about, it pleases me. And I'm loving it because this is the first of the many we're still going to have. Lutheran men must take charge in the contemporary societal reformation. If we want to see this society reforming, if we want to see our communities changing, if we want to see our church reformed, we can't just say, we must do something about it. And we as Lutheran, I think it's a good thing that we are meeting today, on the actual reformation day. So we as men need to sit down and say we must do something about it. Now Sun Tzu, the writer of The Art of War, a Japanese writer, says, if a statesman seeing that war is inevitable and still continues to hesitate to charge first, then he is guilty of the crimes against his own countrymen. Let me explain it this way. If we as leaders of the community, seeing that we have this problem in our community, seeing that women are raped, seeing that men actually rape their own children, fathers have become rapists, and we continue to sit back and say, ah, Modimo tla ne ro pela se fela re mo sa Jesu tla mo dilo tla fetoga. We do nothing about it. Then we are guilty. We are equally guilty for the rape that happened to our young children. Because we do nothing. Remember that evil does not only grow only because there are bad men or there are bad people, but evil grows because good is in, but all of us running through it. We want to initiate a conversation. We want to initiate discussion. Hopefully it doesn't end here. Hopefully we don't talk today and then we keep quiet about it for the rest of our lives. Hopefully we continue to talk about this thing. Hopefully we go back to our communities, we go back to our congregations, we go back to our families, we start to address gender issues in the home, at work, in the communities, and in the church. We also want to initiate a discussion in adding a Lutheran voice in the society's attempt to deal with social ills. Say a Lutheran voice says, not in our name. Lutheran men say, men cannot continue to abuse their children, men cannot go on and abuse their wives, not in our names. We will do something about it. And we also want to talk about women's health, right? I mean, both mentally and physically, banna rnanele tshwa ke tsebe rna bo ntla go mo le a tsela a tsena mo a rona ba department of health le lor test ali le na sa nna go go re hele bona hele bona a syringe go papa ba bona syringe ba tsena ke tsebetse le tswa di doctor a engebe mo le fatseng go nna ba nna fela the poor people because men wouldn't go there. So we want to talk about that. And want to also talk about the fact that men, when you see things happening in your lives that you don't understand, you must raise your head and say, I have a problem. Because men, tigers don't cry, tigers don't cry, those tigers that do not cry die in pain. We want to empower men. We want men to also have that self-actualization, and that is why we have Bomuti Buffer to come and talk to us. Men to share experiences, fears, and ambitions, and to live. And we must.
Yes, stress is a factor that costs a lot. It costs a lot for individuals, for families, for places of work, different places of work where we work, but also it costs a lot for it. It costs the church a lot. In 2008 to 2017, it was supposed to be a Luther decade where we build up for that celebration in where we celebrate 500
internal years. Politics
that are stressing us, the 40 million saga, other things and so on. And these things, they make us angry. And often stress paralyzes a person. But it doesn't only paralyze a person, it paralyzes communities. It paralyzes even sane communities. We have been paralyzed a lot by the shenanigans that is costly in all spheres of life. And you cannot have only one way of dealing with stress. That's why I'm saying we must have a whole person lifestyle approach. You know, as a person, I'm many things. I am an organic being. I'm a living organ. I am also a social being. I'm part of a community. I'm a psychological being and so on. Therefore, one cannot just take one part. We need to have a whole person approach.
So we are going to dwell with rape, kakhulu. And then this rape, or a forceful penetration, is when somebody penetrates you as a woman vaginally or anally, or as a man, you'll always be penetrated in the anus. So it affects everybody equally. Men, women, boy children, girl children. So abantu are under the perception that it's only women and girls that are being raped. So I'll keep on saying penetration. Okay, you rape somebody
without consent.
So it's an incentive rape. Incentive rape is whereby now a male will be maybe apprehended by females, by a female, to say, we are again again. That's rape, because you are not consenting to that. It normally happens, but abobaba, they do not come out easily in most cases. Incentive rape. Then we've got the receptive rape, where the perpetrator does it himself. A penetrator, I say move, penetrator vagina. He's on call like language, your wife.
Call us. The other one should be meeting a one stop center. Mouthy laka. We're getting you show with TCC. Why we TCC? We are working under one roof with the NPA staff, the National Prosecuting Authority staff. There's a qualified advocate who's working there, looking after your cases. And there's a victim assistant officer, or I'm telling which we're not happy about the investigating officer operating case here. Maybe we are mbona the family of a perpetrator, and then there's also a site coordinator who coordinates these services.